One of the keynotes at this Lambda World, this 2070 edition, was in charge of this man who's in my left. He's Jeremy Gibbons. Hello, Jeremy.
Hi. Hi, Emma.
How are you feeling?
I'm good. I'm looking forward to it. It's been great here in Cadiz.
Yeah, it's like the second time you've been here?
It's the first time I've been here.
Oh,
it's the first time in Andalusia, and it's lovely.
Yeah. I can tell that. So, Jeremy, what's the thing you've been talking here today at the keynote?
So it's about a paper I wrote about a language called APL, which is this very cool programming language from the 1960s to program with arrays, so vectors of data and rectangles of data and cuboids of data.
Okay.
And it lets you do very cool things with arrays. So you can, as well as being able to add numbers together, you can add vectors together and you can add matrices together. And you can add numbers to vectors and vectors to matrices and all sorts of weird stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But when the language was defined in the 1960s, there was no static checking for this. So you write a program and you wouldn't find out if it was going to do something silly, like trying to add a short vector to a long vector, until you ran it. And you might not find this out until it's been running for some time and you've forgotten what you were supposed to be doing. So my paper is about preventing certain kinds of errors in these array programs, and rather than building a separate tool to prove that no errors happen, you can embed it within an existing programming language. In my case, that language is Haskell, and the features of Haskell are sufficient to encode the rules that tell you what is a sensible APL program and what is a silly APL program, and lets you write the sensible ones and stops you writing the silly ones.
Okay. And I have question about a concept you used today, the Napierian.
Right, Napierian functors, Napierian applicative functors.
That's right. What's that?
So functors. We just had a talk earlier on introduction to category theory. You think of a functor as representing a container data type, so a data type that has values inside, and an applicative functor has a bit more information there, a bit more structure that tells you that there are things inside at particular positions.
Okay.
And that means if you have two of these things with things inside at particular positions, you can overlay one on top of the other. So you can we call it zipping them together. So you can combine the first thing in one container with the first thing in another, second thing with another, and so on.
Okay.
And then Napierian applicative functors is a bit more structure again. It's where all these things have the same shape. And this allows you to take to transpose matrices. So if you have a row of columns, you can turn it into a column of rows, and that works nicely because of the additional structure that's there with Napierian applicative functors. The name comes from a colleague of mine in the UK called Peter Hancock, and it's a cool name because it's based on he chose it based on John Napier, who is a mathematician who invented logarithms. And these data types behave a bit like logarithms in arithmetic. So this nice Scottish idea from the 1600s.
Yeah. Super cool story. Well, so thank you for your time and enjoy the conference, Jeremy. Yeah.
Thank you very much. Yes.